Alright, first off, new feature. Well, new. Do you remember? In Mario 64 2.0, you could swap the animation and see the change in life. This was removed in 2.1, but it has been re-implemented in the form of a checkbox. Uncheck keeps the original behavior from 2.1, and check will replace the old animation with the new one every time the new animation box changes. By the way, you might have noticed that the reset animation button is, not present. It has actually been removed because it didn't work as expected. It wasn't good enough as a feature, so I took it out. Sorry. I see what I can do later. In 2.1, there was a simple remove HUD button. It worked most of the time, but it had problems with the power meter. A request in the GitHub repository asked to enhance the feature to add more options for removal and addition, and now the power meter also hides properly. This feature may see an improvement change later on the road. This one's a bit exciting for those that use color codes. This new experimental feature called color routing allows you to make parts of Mario's body share colors with other parts, allowing you to do things like, I don't know, fake shorties? This feature actually needs more testing. I am aware it has some caveats, but I am also being restricted by Mario's vanilla model. For example, the shirt color is shared with the M on the hat. Changing just the hat or the shirt separately would look really clashing, and there are many face parts to change. There is one face part per iframe. I will make this more customizable later on. Just you wait. Another new feature I've added is the Atom mechanic, like the plugging mechanic in Vegas or plugging on a file type mechanic in Paint.net. You see, every time Mario 64 Movie Maker had an update, you had to download the whole package to use the new features. And there was a little worry about it. If there were too many things people would not use, the program would be bloated. A lot of not necessary things. This aims to fix that. The add-ons will be downloaded separately, and every version of Mario 64 Movie Maker it says it's compatible with, it would work in it. And the downloads are completely optional. That means no bloat if you just want to have the whole package, the core package with the animation swapping and the HUD buttons, you can have it. If you want more things, you can request them. And if they are not something essential, super essential, it could be made an add-on. Otherwise, it would be just included in the main release, in the main executable. If it's essential enough, it doesn't need to be separate. Now, it can also be used to test other features that are highly experimental and need something else. Perhaps more power. Unfortunately, at this time of recording, there are not really many add-ons for Mario 64 Movie Maker, and